There's been a lot of outcry as the FDA just approved genetically modified animal for human consumption for the first time. Sure, tweak 80% of US food, but keep your test tubes off our salmon. Hey there, organisms. Trace here for DNews. Genetically modified organisms incite heat on both sides of the debate. Many believe genetically modified organisms are more efficient than crossbreeding plants for many generations and crossing their fingers, while detractors believe that we shouldn't genetically modify the food we eat and should keep it natural. I use finger quotes not to make fun, but because what natural means in this context is confusing for many, if not most people, even the FDA gets confused about it. Now, joining the list of tomatoes, potatoes, soy or tofu, rice, cotton, corn, so much corn, canola oil, squash, alfalfa, and mosquitoes is genetically modified salmon. According to AquaAdvantage, the company that modified the fish, the salmon contains genes from the Chinook salmon and an eel-like species, which means it will grow all year and at a faster rate than natural salmon. It will, of course, need to eat much more to grow at such a rate, but it only lives in fish farms, so won't be competing with natural varieties for food. According to the FDA, there are no biologically relevant differences in the nutritional profile of the AquaAdvantage salmon compared to that of other farm-raised Atlantic salmon. And now, they've been approved for human consumption. So they're going to swim their way into some store shelves and on top of our bagels. This has unsurprisingly caused a huge outcry from anti-GMO activists. Some stores are even refusing to sell the genetically modified fish. According to pretty much every scientific group or organization on the planet, genetically modified organisms, or GMOs, are completely 100% safe for humans. There are more than 600 studies on it, all saying the same thing: GMOs are safe, and yet, people are still nervous, and I get why. You're messing with my food, man! Most genetically modified grains sold in the US are used for animal feed, though, according to Consumer Reports, pretty much every human food sample that they tested contained GMOs, except those which explicitly said otherwise, and that included breakfast cereals, baby formula, veggie burgers, and popular chip brands. According to the FDA, this salmon, dubbed a Frankenfish by activist groups, is safe to eat and will allegedly pose no threat to the environment. The FDA approval requires the salmon to live only in fish farms, but even if one did escape somehow, 95% of the fish are sterile. Cross your fingers that any escapee isn't one of the 5%. Some genetically modified grains like canola have been created which don't reproduce at all, like Jurassic Park's lysine contingency. The GMOs just can't live in the wild without the special sauce the lab uses to grow them. We already have genetically modified plants growing in nature all over the US that escaped from farms, and no one knows what's gonna happen with them. This isn't the only GMO animal in the research and approval pipeline. A line of goats was created whose milk can prevent deadly diarrhea in children. The company is marketing it to the government of Brazil, where children still die from diarrhea. A species of chicken was modified, which suppresses the replication of bird flu virus, and pigs are also being bred that are resistant to swine flu. All this sounds pretty good, but it seems to me people do get increasingly uncomfortable as the animals come closer to their tables. In a partnership between Harvard Medical, University of Missouri, and the University of Pittsburgh, a genetically modified pig was created which produces higher omega-3 fatty acids. Omega-3s are essential for health, but aren't synthesized by mammals naturally. Instead, they're found in microorganisms like algae, plankton, and worms. Fish get their omega-3s from algae as well. By modifying a worm enzyme for a pig species, this pig is now a source of omega-3s. There are plans to modify cattle to stop them growing sharp horns, which can be dangerous for farmlands and other cows, but also plans to mix various traits from different cow species to produce more milk or more beef or whatever is required. Genetically modified meat is here. Supporters and company representatives say, as the population continues to increase exponentially, humanity needs food sources that have lesser impacts on the environment. They say these might be the answer. Transgenic animals, those with genes from other species, had yet to be rated as safe for human consumption until now. But according to all the science that's fit to print, GMOs are safe, and this fish is heading out. But how do you feel about it? GMOs are everywhere now, but people still have a misunderstanding of what they even are. Lacey looks into the science of genetic modification here.
GMOs are plants that are genetically engineered by splicing their DNA with other species, producing plant, animal, bacterial, and viral gene combinations that you probably definitely wouldn't find in nature.
Let us know in the comments how you feel about genetically modified foods, salmon or cereals or whatever, and keep coming back here to DNews every day for more videos. Thanks for watching.